This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes the two different budgets that feed into the overall operating budget for a manufacturing company, the capital expenditure budget and the cash budget. So we're going to start by talking about the capital expenditure budget, and then we'll move over into the cash budget a little bit later. The capital expenditure budget provides an estimate of the long-term assets that we would like to purchase as a company during the budget period. So we're talking about, for example, purchases of tangible assets like equipment or factories or it could be vehicles for a company, whatever it might be. Those are all tangible assets. So that is one piece of the capital expenditure budget. It would also present any intangible asset purchases that we might want to make. So for example, maybe we want to buy a patent from another manufacturing company and use that patent for our own manufacturing process. That would be included in the capital expenditure budget. Here's an example of the capital expenditures budget for a company that I use throughout all of my operating budget examples. I've posted videos for all of the operating budgets for a company called Jerry's Ice Cream, and they all link together. So the two budgets that you're going to see in this video relate to the other videos also having to do with operating budgets. What Jerry's Ice Cream is planning to do for this coming year, this is for the year ended December 31, and it's set up by quarter. They are planning not to make any purchases in the first three quarters of the year, but in the fourth quarter, they are planning to make two purchases, one for selling and administrative computers, and the other for production equipment. And you'll see here that the computers are expected to cost $10,000, and the production equipment is expected to cost $15,000. We then summarize this quarterly information for the year. So that's what you see in the far right here. And there's some information at the bottom in the footnote. You can take a look at that on your own. We'll spend a little more time looking at the cash budget for Jerry's Ice Cream. This is an important budget for most organizations, and there are many different components to it. So the cash budget, it provides an estimate of the amount and timing, which is really important, of cash inflows and outflows for the budget period that we're looking at. It has three sections. The first section has to do with cash collections from sales. The second section has cash payments for purchases of materials. And then the last section is sort of a catch-all, any other cash collections and payments. So let's take a look at this. We're going to look at it in two different slides since there's so much information. So let's start on the next slide by looking at cash collections and cash payments. Here's the cash budget for Jerry's Ice Cream. And again, it's for the year ending December 31. So we have it broken out by quarter. Here's the first quarter, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter, and then collectively, far right, the collectively for the year. As I mentioned, we're going to show two sections on this slide, and then we'll show the last section on the next slide. So the first section that you see here is the cash collections from sales budget. And it really is all about timing. When do we expect to receive the cash related to the sales that we make? Particularly if we make sales on account, when do we expect to see that cash come in? So there's often a lag between when we make the sale and when we collect the cash. It's not as simple as just saying, here are the sales, so here's the cash we receive in that period. The assumption that we're making here, if you look at the footnote at the very bottom down here, is that, and this is just a given, it depends on the company, is that all sales are on credit, and that we're going to collect about 60% in the quarter of the sale, and about 40% the following quarter. So let's look at the sales from the second quarter here. In the second quarter, we made sales totaling $288,000 on account. That's the assumption that we're using here. And we know that we're going to collect 60% of that $288,000 in the quarter of the sale. So we're going to collect $172,800 in the second quarter related to the second quarter sales of $288,000. And I've got a little notation here to that effect. So that 172,800 is the 60% times $288,000. And then we're going to collect 40% of those credit sales the following quarter. So that's 40% times $288,000 gives us $115,200. So that's how we map out the cash flows. This can be set up a number of different ways. This is just one example, but typically it takes time over several quarters to collect on our accounts receivable, or at least over several months if we were doing this monthly. But we'll assume here that each quarter we're going to have a lag in when we make the sale and when we collect the cash on some of those sales. So that's how we set it up. And what we're trying to get at here is how much are we going to see in total cash collections each quarter related to our sales. And now this shows you how to figure that out. And of course, what that number will be, not just quarterly, but for the year. The second piece of this, what you see on this slide for the cash budget, relates to cash payments for purchases of materials. And it's really the same concept as cash collections. That is, we're going to buy materials on credit, and we'll pay for some of those materials in the quarter that we make the purchase, and we'll pay for some of those materials in the quarter following the purchase. And the second footnote down here describes that. So in the second footnote, you see that we are going to pay for 70% of our purchases in the quarter of the purchase, and then 30% the following quarter. I'll use the second quarter as an example again. Here's the second quarter right here. And let's assume that we purchased $102,400 in materials on account, on credit, and that 70% is going to be paid in the quarter in which we make the purchase, and 30% will be paid the quarter following the purchase. So this $71,680 equals 70% of this $102,400. So we take 70% of that, and that's $71,680, and then the remaining 30% will be paid the following quarter. Once we figure out the timing of these cash flows and when we're going to make these payments, we can then map it out and figure out how much we have to pay out each quarter. And you see that down here at the bottom, right? And for the year. And this is really helpful for our treasurer, because the treasurer wants to know how much money do we have coming in, that's the cash collections budget, and how much money do we have going out, and do we have enough to be able to pay the bills, and if not, we need to make arrangements. If there's a lag between when we make the sale and when we get the money, we have to make arrangements for perhaps a line of credit to make those payments for the materials. Since I wasn't able to show you the entire cash budget on the previous slide, this is basically an extension of the budget that you saw on the previous slide. So it's really all one big document, but I split it out just to make it a little bit easier to explain. So this is the third section of the cash budget, and it's just everything else. It's everything outside of what you saw on the first slide related to the cash coming from sales and the cash for payments related to the purchase of materials. So here you'll see the other cash payments. This is the section right here. And what you see here relates to direct labor and manufacturing overhead, selling administrative, and capital expenditures. Again, this relates to the other videos that I've got out there related to the operating budgets for manufacturing companies, specifically for Jerry's Ice Cream. It all links together and all the numbers flow together. So I don't just make these numbers up. They came from the other budgets that you saw for Jerry's Ice Cream in the other videos. So for example, with the direct labor budget, we noticed that there were going to be cash payments looking like this. So that's the first quarter right here, and the second quarter, and the third quarter, and the fourth quarter. And then again, this is for the year. So those cash flows come from those other budgets, and we expect to see these cash outflows related to direct labor, and these cash outflows here, the second line related to manufacturing overhead costs, and these cash outflows related to selling and administrative costs, and lastly for capital expenditures. And then we total up these other cash, these happen to be cash payments, so we total up these other cash payments by quarter, so that's what these numbers represent here. And then of course, for collectively for the year, we expect to see cash outflow for these other cash payments of $705,720. And then what we're doing in this next line here, this excess of collections over payments, is and you can look at the footnote. It describes this very clearly down here. These footnotes describe exactly what's going on. The excess of collections over payments is just a net of what you saw on the previous slide and what you see on this slide. So in the first quarter, we're expecting to see, for example, cash collections of $81,088. In the second quarter, a net cash collection amount of $3,072, and so on. And for the year, net cash collections of $145,576. And then in the last two lines here, we simply want to know, what is our ending cash balance going to look like at the end of each quarter? So we started in the first quarter with $10,000 in cash. We expect to see the cash receipts or cash collections of $81,088. So collectively, if you take these two numbers, add them together, we are looking at a cash balance at the end of the first quarter of $91,088. So again, this is helpful for the treasurer so that we know we have enough cash to get through the quarter and into the next quarter. So you'll see this running balance of our cash account each quarter and collectively for the year.